فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. Inshallah ta'ala, as we promised last lesson, we're going to be taking بإذنالله الكريم نماذج and أمثلة من سير أئمة السنة في عدم تكفير بعض المعينين لتخلف شروط التكفير في حقهم. We're going to take examples of some of the leading scholars in Islam that they didn't place takfir on particular individuals because the conditions were not there. Because we've taken what the conditions are, some of these conditions they could not find it on a particular individual, so they didn't place takfir on them. The first example, المثال الأول, the first example is موقف الإمام أحمد بن حنبل, the position that Imam Ahmad رحمه الله he took from the خلفاء, from the leaders الذين كانوا يقولون بخلق القرآن, those who were saying that the Quran is created. And they were three leaders. They were three leaders من خلفاء العباسيين. The Abbasi dynasty, there were three of them who were saying this. The first one is Al-Ma'mun. And the second one is Al-Mu'tasim. And the last one, which is Al-Wathiq. These three, they got affected by بمذهب المعتزلة. They got affected by the methodology of the Mu'tazila. And they took this false methodology and this false belief. And they called the people, these leaders, they called the people to this belief. And they tested them on it. So it wasn't just you had to believe it, but you were getting tested. They were coming to you, they were asking you, what's your position regarding the Quran? And anyone who did not respond by referring to the Quran as created, he would be imprisoned, he would be lashed, and some of them would be killed. Or some of them got killed. And Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he was from those a'imma, he was from those ulama who ثبت على قول أهل السنة. He kept steadfast on the statement of the ulama. On the statement of أهل السنة والجماعة. I mean, Imam Ahmad, he stuck to the view of أهل السنة والجماعة, which is that أن القرآن كلام الله, that the Quran is the speech of Allah, ليس بمخلوق, and it is not created. And because of that, Imam Ahmad رحمه الله تعرض بسبب ذلك. Because of that, he went through and he endured ابتلاء عظيم. Great calamity, Imam Ahmad. And he received from that statement of his, which is that the Quran is the speech of Allah and it's not created, he received from that jild. He got lashed and he got imprisoned for a very long time. Until Imam Ahmad kada an yamuta بسبب ذلك. He was about to die from that. And Imam Ahmad was about to die from the lashing and from the beating and from the, he was about to die from it. واشتهرا, this period of time, it got known as, it got referred to as al-mihna. The scholars, they refer to this period as the mihna. If you want to see more in details regarding the what happened and how and the details of it, then you can go to the kitab Hilyatul Awliya wa Tabaqatul Asfiya by Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani rahimahullah, 9th volume, page 193 to 206, Or you could go to Kitab Al-Bidayah wa Nihaya by Ibn Kathir, 14th volume, page 393 to 405. Or you could go to Sirah Alam al-Nubala by Imam al-Dhahabi. You can go to the 11th volume, you can 11th volume, page 238 to 265. You'll find so much details and so much explanation and discussion regarding what had taken place. So Al-Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he was steadfast at this period of time, this time which the ulama refer to as the waqtul fitna, the mihna. And Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he did not place takfir on the khulafa, on the leaders, on this statement which they said that the Quran is what? That the Quran is makhluq. And Imam Ahmad didn't do takfir on them. And they didn't just believe it. No. وَإِكْرَاهِ النَّاسِ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. They were forcing the people onto it. And Imam Ahmad rahimahullah is from the scholars who transmitted consensus that anyone who says that the Quran is created is a kafir. And there is a consensus on this issue. You can find it in the Kitab Ar-Raddu Ala Al-Jahmiyyah by Imam Ad-Darimi rahimahullah and Sharh Usul I'tiqadi Ahli Sunnah Wal Jama'ah by Abu Qasim Hibatullahi Al-Lalaka'i. And also Majmu' al-Fatawa by Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah and the Nuniyah of Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. The ulama are by consent, they are in agreement that what? That saying the Quran is makhluq, that the Quran is created bi ijma'i aimat al-Sunnah, it is kufr. But Ahmed rahimahullah, he didn't do takfir of these people, these leaders. Why? لِتَأَوُّلِهِمْ. Because they had one of the conditions, conditions were missing for takfir, which is that they shouldn't have interpretation. لِتَخَلُّفُ شُرُوطِ التَّكْفِيرِ فِي حَقِّهِمْ. One of the conditions of takfir was missing. Interpretation was present. They had an interpretation of all of that. وَلِأَنَّهُمْ لَبَّسَ عَلَيْهِمْ أَهْلُ الْبِدْعَ. That the innovators, the Mu'tazila, are the ones who brought these interpretations to them. And they mixed the matter up for them. So the truth didn't become clear to the leaders. Rather, Al-Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he forgave those who did what they did to him. And he made dua for them. And Imam Ahmad said, كُلُّ مَنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي حِلٍّ فَفِي حِلٍّ. And Imam Ahmad said, everybody who mentioned me is what? في حِلٍّ, is free, inshaAllah ta'ala. Meaning that he won't be held account for anything. إِلَّا مُبْتَدِعًا, except an innovator. إِلَّا مُبْتَدِعًا, except an innovator. وَقَدْ جَعَلْتُ أَبَا إِسْحَاقٍ. And I have made Abu Ishaq. Abu Ishaq here is who? Al-Mu'tasim. And I have made Abu Ishaq, meaning the leader Al-Mu'tasim, في حِلٍ. I've freed him as well. وَرَأَيْتُ اللَّهَ يَقُولُ I heard Allah say, or I saw Allah say, وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Forgive and forget. Do you not love for Allah to forgive you? وَأَمَرَ النَّبِيُّ, Allah commanded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَأَمَرَ النَّبِيُّ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet commanded, sorry, أَبَا بَكْرٍ, the Prophet commanded Abu Bakr, to what? بِالْعَفْوِ فِي قِصَّةِ مِصْطَحٍ, in the story pertaining to Mistah, because Mistah was from those people who were the tale-bearers, who carried on the news pertaining to Aisha. Okay? And this is, Mistah was under the who? Mistah was under the wing of who? Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr was taking care. Abu Bakr was taking care of who? Mistah. Abu Bakr was taking care of what? Mistah. So the Prophet said to Abu Bakr, forgive Mistah. Even though he was a tale bearer of what happened, forgive him and carry on giving him the provision that you were giving him. Abu Abdullah, so all of this, Ibn Kathir is bringing his Kitab al-Bidayah wa Nihayah. He said, قَالَ أَبُو عَبْدِ اللَّهِ وَمَا يَنْفَعُكَ أَنْ يُعَذِّبَ اللَّهُ أَخَاكَ الْمُسْلِمَ فِي سَبِيلِكَ. Powerful statement Imam Ahmad said. He said, وَمَا يَنْفَعُكَ What would it benefit you? أَنْ يُعَذِّبَ اللَّهُ That Allah punishes أَخَاكَ your Muslim brother, أَخَاكَ الْمُسْلِمِ Allah punishes your Muslim brother في سبيلك because of you. What would it benefit? What would you gain from it? That if Allah punishes a Muslim person because of you, what would you benefit from it personally? There's nothing. Al-Bidayah wa Nihayah Ibn Kathir brings it in the 14th volume, page 404 up to 405. Imam al-Dahabi brings it in the Sirah Alam al-Nubala, 11th volume, page 261. So what do you see from this? The fact that Imam Ahmad said, مَا يَنْفَعُكَ أَن يُعَذِّبَ اللَّهُ أَخَاكَ الْمُسْلِمَ أَخَاكَ الْمُسْلِمَ Who's he referring to أَخَاكَ الْمُسْلِمَ? Al-Mu'tasim. He's referring to Al-Mu'tasim. What would it benefit you for Allah to punish your Muslim brother for you? Are you there? So this is a clear indication. This is dalil which is wadih that Imam Ahmad rahimahullah لم يكفرهم. He didn't do takfir of on them. Are you with me? مع ما أظهروه من الكفر. Even that they brought out clear-cut kufr. They came with things which were clear-cut. وما فعلوه من الظلم. And the oppression and the wrongdoings that they came with, he did not do takfir on them. He did not do takfir on them. مجموع الفتاوى, if you look at the 23rd volume, page 348 to 349, شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية says the following. He says, ومع هذا, and even then, فالذين كانوا من ولاة الأمور يقولون بالجهمية إن القرآن مخلوق وإن الله لا يرى في الآخرة. He said, even though these leaders who are saying the statement of the Jahmiyyah that the Quran is created and that Allah will not be seen the day of judgment, وغير ذلك, and other than that, ويدعون الناس, and they call the people إلى ذلك to that matter, ويمتحنونهم, and they test the people on that, ويعاقبونهم, and they punish them based on that, إذ لم يجيبوهم, when they don't obey them in it, ويكفرون من لم يجبهم, and they even place takfir on those who don't obey them, حتى إنهم كانوا إذا أمسكوا الأسيرة, to the extent that if they grabbed a captive, لم يطلقوه, they will not let him go حتى يقر بقول الجهمية, until he said the statement of the جهمية, which is إن القرآن مخلوق وغير ذلك, and other than that, ولا يولون متوليا ولا يعطون رزقا, they do not take allegiance to the one who they should take allegiance as, and they do not give provision from the بيت المال المسلمين, the Muslim treasury, they don't take money and they don't give it to these people, إلا لمن يقول, except the person who says that the Quran is created. ومع هذا, and even then, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah says, فالإمام أحمد رحمه الله ترحم عليهم, and Imam Ahmad sent رحمة on them. واستغفر لهم, and he asked Allah's forgiveness for them. لعلمه, because he knew, بأنهم لم يبين لهم. He knows that Imam Ahmad knew that it wasn't clarified to them. أنهم مكذبون للرسل, that these individuals who've told them this are disbelievers of the messenger. وَلَا جَاحِدُونَ لِمَا جَاءَ بِهِ, and that they are stubborn, hard-headed individuals pertaining to that which the Prophet came with. وَلَكِنْ تَأَوَّلُوا فَأَخْطَأُوا, rather, Imam Ahmad believed that these leaders' interpretation was put in front of them, so they took that interpretation and they got it wrong. وَقَلَّدُوا, and they blind followed مَنْ قَالَ لَهُمْ ذَلِكَ, those who said that statements to them. Are you with me, brothers? They didn't take fear of them. Because Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he can see one of the conditions that he needs to be absent is there in front of him. There's a condition which is adam ta'wil al-sa'igh. The person can't have a what? An understandable interpretation which is there. The second example is موقف شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية من مخالفيه. Ibn Taymiyyah in regards to his opponents. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah as example in this matter as well. He did not do takfir on some people who came with clear-cut kufr. Because it was clear to Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah that these individuals, the proof hasn't been established on them. Look what he said. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah is saying this. He said, هَذَا مَعَنِّي دَائِمًا. Ibn Taymiyyah is saying this. And this, even that though I always, وَمَنْ جَالَسَنِي يَعْلَمُ ذَلِكَ مِنِّي. And anyone who sits with me knows this of me. أَنِّي مِنْ أَعْظَمِ النَّاسِ نَهْيًا عَنْ أَنْ يُنْسَبَ مُعَيَّنٌ إِلَى تَكْفِيرٍ وَتَفْسِيقٍ وَمَعْصِيَةٍ. That I am from the greatest people who prohibit for takfir to be stipulated to a particular individual, or even tafsiq, that is a fasiq, or even to say he's a wrongdoer. I am the furthest, and I am one of the greatest people who's known to stop, prevent people from that. Jameel. Illa idha ulima annahu qad qamat alayhi al-hujjatu ar-risaliyah. Except if it's known that the message has been established on this person and the proof has been brought to them. Allati man khalafaha, that proof, whoever opposes it, kana kafiran taratan, sometimes he might become a kafir for leaving it. Wa fasiqan ukhra, sometimes he may even become a fasiq. You see. وَعَاصِيًا أُخْرَى, and sometimes he may be even a sinner. وَإِنِّي أُقَرِّرُ, I am here establishing, أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ غَفَرَ لِهَذِي الْأُمَّةَ خَطَأَهَا. Ibn Taymiyyah said, so look, some people are in a position, what they're going against may lead them to what? Kufr. Or it may lead them to what? Ma'asiyah and fisq. Are you with me? So the proof needs to be established. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, he says, and I also establish, أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ غَفَرَ لِهَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ خَطَأَهَا. Allah has forgiven this ummah for its mistakes. وَذَلِكَ يَعُمُّ, and these mistakes encompass, فِي الْمَسَائِلِ الْخَبَرِيَّةِ الْقَوْلِيَّةِ وَالْمَسَائِلِ الْعَمَلِيَّةِ. Allah forgives, subhanahu wa ta'ala, matters which are خَبَرِيَّةِ قَوْلِيَّةِ, عَقِيدَ related mistakes. And Allah also forgives matters which are fiqh related. Are we all together? Forgives them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَخِذْنَا إِن نَسِينَا أَوْ أَخْطَأْنَا. And in hadith Sahih Muslim, which says, قَدْ فَعَلْتُ, I have done that. It encompasses everything. Whether it be aqidah related matter or whether it be a fiqh related matter, Allah forgives, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَقُولُ رَأْ, so Ibn Taymiyyah says that. He says in another place, rahimahullah, ولهذا كان ولهذا كنت أقول للجهمية من الحلولية والنفات. Ibn Taymiyyah says, I used to say to the Jahmiyyah, من الحلولية, like those who believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he now is inside his creation. والنفات, and the ones who are negators. الذين نفوا أن الله تعالى فوق العرش, those who have negated that Allah is above his throne. لما وقعت محنتهم, when the calamity came and the problem occurred. أنا أَنَّا لَوْ وَافَقْتُكُمْ كُنْتُ كَافِرًا. When the calamity came, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah is talking about his time, his mihna. When the mihna happened, that they were prisoning him, and Imam, he said to them in one of the debates, Ibn Taymiyyah said to them in one of the debates, أَنَا لَوْ وَافَقْتُكُمْ, if I agree with you today on what you guys believe, كُنْتُ كَافِرًا, I'm a disbeliever. Ibn Taymiyyah would be a kafir. لأني أعلم أن قولكم كفر, because I know your statement is كفر. وأنتم عندي لا تكفرون, but you guys to me are not gonna, you guys are not gonna become كفار. لأنكم جهال, because you're ignorant. Are you with me? You guys are ignorant. وكان هذا خطابا لعلمائهم وقضائهم وقضاتهم وشيوخهم. Ibn Taymiyyah said this was an addressing to their what? Their scholars. He's talking to who? Their scholars. He's talking to their judges and their mashayikh. Wa umara'im, and their leaders. Wa aslu jahlihim, and it's the asal of their doubt was what? Shubuhat aqliyah. What was in front of them were rational doubts. Doubts that came from logic and thinking like that. Hasanat liru'usihim, في قصور من معرفة المنقول الصحيح والمعقول الصحيح صريح الموافق له. So that is the kalam of what? Also Shaykh Islam ibn Taymiyyah said in his kitab Sharh al-Aqidah al-Asfahaniya, Shaykh Islam ibn Taymiyyah said ثم الفلاسفة والباطنية هم كفار كفر ظاهر عند المسلمين. He said the philosopher, the philosophers, and the batiniya, they are kuffar, and their kufr is clear to the Muslims. Then Ibn Taymiyyah carries on saying, after a while, لكن, but, لا يعرف كفرهم. Their kufr is not known. من لم يعرف حقيقة قولهم. Their kufr is not known unless you know the reality of their statement and what it really implies and what it really means. وَقَدْ يَكُولُ, and it could sometimes happen, قَدْ تَشَبَّتَ بِبَعْضِ أَقْوَالِهِمْ, it could happen that some people may hold on to their statements, the philosophers and the batiniya statements. Some people may hold on to their statements, مَنْ لَمْ يَعْرِفْ أَنَّهُ كُفْرٌ, who do not know it's kufr. فَيَكُونُ, and they become مَعْذُورًا لِجَهْلِهِ, they then become excuse for their ignorance. He said this in his شرح العقيدة الأصفهانية, page 211. So Shaykh Islam ibn Taymiyyah has a lot of examples like that. رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. We're now going to give the third example of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. Here we find in Muhammad Abdul Wahhab distinguishing between what? بين الحكم المطلق والحكم المعين. رحمه الله تعالى. Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, what does he say? وإذا كنا لا نكفر. Ibn Taymiyyah, Muhammad Abdul Wahhab said, we don't do takfir on من عبد الصنم, the one who worships an idol. من عبد الصنم الذي على قبة عبد القادر, who worships the shrine of عبد القادر الجيلاني, وصنم الذي على قبر أحمد البدوي, and also the idol which is on the grave of أحمد البدوي, وأمثالهما, and the likes of these, لأجل جهلهم, because of their ignorance, وعدم من ينبههم, and because they have no one to bring it to their attentions. فكيف نكفر من لم يشرك بالله. How could then we become those who do takfir on people who haven't even done shirk? Are you there? إذا لم يهاجر إلينا ولم يكفر ولم يقاتل. And how can we do takfir on somebody because they haven't migrated to us, or they haven't made takfir and they haven't fought with us? سبحانك هذا بهتان عظيم. Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab said, والله سبحانallah, exalted is Allah, هذا بهتان عظيم. This is a great accusation that's made against us. This is in his fatawa wa masail Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, page 11. And I told you this mas'ala, which is shirk akbar, whether it takes an udhr bil jahl or whatnot, and the tafasil of the qawl of a'immat da'wati najriya, it needs explanation. What does it need? It needs explanation. And our mawqif is clear that if a person falls into shirk akbar, فإنه لا يعذر. If a person falls into shirk akbar, he's not excused. He's not excused. He also said in his مجموع مؤلفات الشيخ محمد الرسائل الشخصية, third volume, page 33. And also you can look at, if you want, third volume, page 58. Ibn عبد الوهاب says, Muhammad عبد الوهاب says, ما ذكر لكم, that which has been mentioned to you, عني regarding me, أني أكفر بالعموم, that I just unrestrictedly make takfir of people, that I just go there and I just blast people with takfir. فهذا من بهتان الأعداء. These are the false accusations of the enemies. وذلك قولهم أني أقول, and this is their statement, which is that I say, من تبع دين الله ورسوله وهو ساكن في بلده أنه ما يكفي حتى يجيء عندي. One of their lies against me is that anyone who follows the religion of Islam, who follows the religion of the Prophet ﷺ, and he lives in his own land, that if he doesn't come to me and if he doesn't reside with me, that he's a kafir. They made this against me. فَهَذَا أَيْضًا مِنَ الْبُهْتَانِ. That's also from the false, forged allegations against us. إِنَّمَا الْمُرَادُ اتِّبَاعُ دِينِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. What I intend by my statement is that Allah's religion and the Prophet's religion is followed. في أي أرض كانت, it can be wherever in the world it wants. ولكن نكفر من أقر بدين الله. But we make takfir on the person who affirms the religion of Allah and the Messenger. ثم عاداه, but he shows enmity towards it. وصد الناس عنه, and then he blocks the people from the religion of Allah. He becomes an obstacle from the people entering the religion. وكذلك من عبد الأوثان. And we also make takfir on the one who worship idols. بعد ما عرف أنه دين للمشركين. After he comes to know that this is the religion of the pagans. وَزِينَةٌ لِلنَّاسِ, and a beautification. وَزَيَّنَهُ لِلنَّاسِ, sorry. And he beautifies it for the people. فَهَذَا الَّذِي أُكَفِّرُهُ. This is the one I place takfir on. وَكُلُّ عَالِمٍ عَلَى وَجْهِ الْأَرْضِ يُكَفِّرُ هَؤُلَاء. And any scholar on the face of this earth will also do takfir of those people. إِلَّا رَجُلًا, except a man, مُعَانِدًا, who is stubborn and hard-headed, or جَاهِلًا, or who is ignorant. He was also asked, rahimahullah, from the questions that were put to him. He said, when he was asked about مسائل في التكفير, he said, إِنِّي أُكَفِّرُ الْبُوصِرِ بِقَوْلِهِ. I place takfir on Busiri for his statement, يَا أَكْرَمُ الْخَلْقِ. Busiri is Burda. فَجَوَابِي فِيهَا, my response to that statement is, the ones who have said, I make takfir on Busiri for his statement, يَا أَكْرَمَ الْخَلْقِ, my response to this is, سُبْحَانَكَ هَذَا بُهْتَانٌ عَظِيمٌ. Exalted Allah, this is a what? It's a forged allegation against me. Are you there? Is the statement kufr? Naam. We don't deny that statement is kufr. But do we make takfir on Busiri? Nah. We don't make takfir on him. So these are statements which are مَبْثُوثٌ فِي كُتُبِهِ. If you look at Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab's works, you find all of that scattered in his works. رحمه ta'ala. That Imam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, that he doesn't do takfir unless the conditions of takfir are present. Even though he might make takfir on this mas'ala, ala what? In what form? He might say kufr mutlaq, but when it comes to ta'yin shakhs, which is mu'ayyan, a particular individual, if the shurut is not there, to him he will not make takfir on them.